I have a reproduction of the 1919 Ordnance Survey map of Exeter and Sidmouth, highlighting the railway line that was closed in 1967 by the Beeching Cuts. This 18-mile route from Fenison to Budley, Salterton and Exmouth will be explored in three stages, starting at Fenison. So let's go walking Devon. I caught the Hatch Green bus from Sidmouth to Fenison and started my walk from the Fenison train station. Although the Sidmouth junction that once existed at the station is no longer visible due to housing development, I'll be searching for any remnants of the railway line, including brickwork, during my walk. Although much of the line is on private property, there are still sections available to walk along. On this first leg of the journey, I'll be following the Ordnance Survey route from Fenison to Tipton St John. I'll put a link in the description for the Ordnance Survey route. The first visible sign of the railway line can be seen by peeking over this bridge, but you get a close look at the bridge once you get down on the footpath. This section of the line would have gone through this orchard here. You'll soon come across brickwork, indicating the line's lower elevation with bank sides that has since been filled in. Crossing over the busy A30, you soon come across these bridges along the way. After you've walked through the bridges, you'll get on a path that follows the exact route of the railway line. Along this path, there's two bridges. The first one is over an old road that leads to Ash Farm, and the second one provided access to the farmer's land. I continue on down the path and join the River Otter. The train line runs adjacent to the River Otter all the way down to Budley Salterton, but I'm only going as far as Tipton today. I eventually get to Gosford Bridge. Just up the road towards Gosford, we can see evidence of the railway line crossing the road. The barriers are long gone, but the concrete posts that the gates hinged on remain. There may even be some of the original gate integrated into this modern gate. The railway line continues along private land, so I follow the footpath towards Ottery St Mary, enjoying the walk and the scenery. If you're enjoying this video, please pop down and give it a like. And if you want to watch more of this type of content, please make sure you're subscribed. When I reached the road that leads to Ottery St Mary, I turned right to see where the line would have crossed this road. To stay safe, I walked on the right-hand side of the road, facing oncoming traffic. There are convenient alcoves on this bridge so that I could step aside from the traffic. Just here by Cadhay Cottage, you can see the gates for the railway crossing buried in the hedge. I head back towards Ottery St Mary, staying on the right-hand side of the road as before, and took the path by the car park that leads to the old Griston flour mill. This mill dates back to at least the 11th century, and the present mill and millstream were built between 1788 and 1793 alongside a wool factory. The millstream was used to power the mill and the mill wheel in the factory. The level of the millstream was maintained by returning surplus water to the river via this tumbling weir. This actually looks like one of the millstones by the weir. The mill stopped operating in 1937 and later became Ottermill Switchgear, which closed in 2003 and is now converted into apartments. The old Ottery train station is still standing and now a business. Just over the road, you can see where the line would have crossed the road, but there's no evidence, as far as I can see, of any remains. I follow the path by the river and soon am able to get on track, quite literally. There is some brickwork remaining here, but you can clearly see how straight this section is. It's lovely to walk this bit. There's a newly planted orchard here that you can walk through. This is going to be great for future generations to enjoy. Eventually you get back to the river and follow the footpath. You used to be able to walk this section of the railway, but it's since been fenced off by the farmer, understandably to protect the sheep. It wasn't the nicest of days regarding the weather, but the rain was light and it didn't bother me. You have to get used to the rain here in Devon, because the result is some beautiful green scenery in the summer. Further down the river, before you get to the old mill, you'll see this Archimedes screw that pumps water. I find it quite interesting. Just here is another section of the disused railway line that you can walk along before going over this lovely bridge just before Tipton St John. This is the end of my walk for today. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and keep an eye out for the next section of this walk. So until next time, take care.